Well, we are live again, live at 5, keeping up with the Stoneses, and we are so excited to just be coming to you through Facebook again, and we're just going to believe God that He's going, we got some things that we're going to share with you. Hey, but let's get started with this first song. How's this? I'm glad I'm saved by the grace of Jesus Christ.
I've been saved by grace. My name is in the book of life, and my sins are washed away. Saved by grace. I've been saved by grace. It's not what I deserve, but I'm saved by grace. Saved by grace, I've been saved by grace. My name is in the book of life, and my sins are washed away. Saved by grace, I've been saved by grace. It's not what I deserve, but I'm saved by grace. When I reach that city, the gates swing open wide. Gonna sing redemption story, how He brought me from the other side. Saved by grace, I've been saved by grace. My name is in the book of life, and my sins are washed away. Saved by grace, saved by grace. It's not what I deserve, but I'm saved by grace. It's not what I deserve, but I'm saved by grace. It's not what I deserve, but I'm saved by grace.
Amen and amen. Saved by the grace of Jesus Christ. The Bible says where sin did abound, grace did much more abound. And it's so exciting to have you tuning in today. One of the things we wanted to share with you, I think it was quite amazing, is because of you. And let me just tell you from the beginning, it's not about Jack and Deb.
Never has
it's
been.
All about Jesus Christ. We had over 1,900 views with 53 shares. And I'm reminded of what the Word of God says. This gospel shall be preached in all the world, and then the end's going to come. And I tell you what, I don't know if Facebook knows it or not, but they're being very instrumental in letting all these ministries, all these churches, and we thank God that you've tuned in. Hey, here's another song. I'm glad that we know that Jesus is alive and well. When Mary came to the tomb, Jesus was gone. But she saw two angels in white. She heard Jesus say, "Woman, why weepest thou? Go tell the disciples I'm alive."
She found the morning star shining. She found the rock of ages standing. She found the rose of Sharon blooming. She found Jesus alive.
Mary was the first to find Jesus alive, the one whose 7 demons were cast out. She loved Jesus more than all of the rest. She knew what the cross was all about.
She found the morning star shining. She found the rock of ages standing. She found the rose of Sharon blooming. She found Jesus alive.
And while you're there, just say a big amen, because He's still alive. Some people think of Jesus that he lived long ago. They read about what history has to tell. They never come to know his resurrection power. I want you to know he's alive and well. I found the morning star shining.
I found the morning star shining.
I found the rock of ages standing.
I found the rock of ages standing.
I found the rose of Sharon blooming.
I found the rose of Sharon blooming.
I found Jesus alive.
You know that.
I found the morning star shining.
Shining.
Yeah.
I found the rock of ages standing.
Standing. I found the rose of Sharon blooming. I found Jesus alive. I found Jesus alive. Amen and amen. I'm glad that he is alive and well. And he knows what's going on in your situation. Deb, we've had so many prayer requests this last week. People would send me a message. And if you have a prayer request, we're going to take them to the throne of God, because I believe that God is still moving. He's working through this, and we're seeing great and mighty things happen.
Can I just tell them about how the Lord dealt with me on prayer?
Sure.
You just talked about prayer requests. Before this quarantine and the virus was telling people to stay away, this was when you could still go out to the restaurants.
Right.
Jack and I had gone out to a restaurant one day around noon, and this young waitress had come up, and Jack gave her his drink order, and then he went to the restroom, and I was standing there, and I reached over and I tapped the young lady, and I said, "Honey," I said, "we're going to be praying over our food before we eat. Is there something that I can pray with you about?" And she started doing this with her hand, and I said, "Oh, you don't have to be specific, just say yes." And
right.
I said, "Jack and I, my husband and I, will pray for you." And she said, no, she said, "This has touched me." She said, "I want you to help me to pray to be more focused."
Yeah.
And so that's what Jack and I did. Well, that night when we were home, and Jack and I had finished praying our prayer before we go to sleep at night, and I was laying there just talking to the Lord, to myself, and I was praying for that young lady
right.
again. And the Lord said, "What about you, Deb?" And I said, "What?" And he says, "What about you being more focused with
yeah.
your prayer?" And I said, "Lord, help me, show me, teach me what you mean to be more focused." And he showed me, he said, and here's what he told me he wanted me to do. He said, "I want you to focus on the people that I have brought into your life, your family, in the order that they've come into your life." And I said, "Okay." And he said, "The first one that I brought to you was Jack as your husband."
Amen.
And I wrote down a list. And the first one was Jack. And then the next one was Misty, our oldest daughter. The next one was Micah. And then our middle child, our next one was Joey. Then the next one that came in was Steve, our son-in-law. Then Mackenzie, our oldest grandchild. Then came Stephanie, our daughter-in-law. And then came Summer, Benjamin, Avery, and then Lily and Jacob.
Amen.
And then the Lord said, "But that's not all." He said, and Jack brought this to my mind. He said, "What about you, Deb?"
Yeah.
And I thought, we always think it's selfish if we pray for ourselves, but it's not, because
yeah.
I have found, especially here in the last few months, I need prayer.
Amen.
And sometimes there's no one around to pray for me. Jack may be out somewhere, and I have to stand on my own two feet and on my prayer and say, "Lord, I need you." And I'm going to tell you, when I first started that, our daughter and her husband, the first day I prayed for them, they got to purchase a home that they wanted.
Amen.
The next day, our other daughter, she got a new job that
Amen.
Was a blessing to her. So let me tell you, folks, prayer works.
Amen.
And I cover my family and my friends in the blood of Jesus every day with prayer.
And you'd be surprised at how many people we are calling upon the Lord. I had a lady tell me that she said, pray for us for our church. One lady, she said, Jack, I have stage 4 cancer. And it's just like this virus. There's no name above Jesus Christ. And I tell you what, we as the body of Christ are binding together. And I've seen more unity through the body of Christ. And we're seeing things happen, even though we're having to be quarantined. But I'm going to tell you, God is still on the throne. Now, I understand that most of us never complain to the Lord.
Let me tell you, if you pray, you better. Why are you praying if you don't believe?
Well, exactly. Well, and another thing, when Deb and I do go out, we were challenged several years ago. We did a revival, and her second cousin challenged us. We went to a restaurant that day, me and him and the pastor, and he asked the young lady, I see you got a cross on your neck. He said, can I ask you, where you go to church? And her response was, I go to the Catholic church. And he said, praise God. And he said these words, he said, well, we're about to pray over our food. Is there anything we can pray with you about? Well, at that time, that young lady was getting ready to go to college, and we prayed for her. And I shared this so many times. People don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. And I know, like I say, we don't complain, but I want you to listen to the words of this next song, because this is our prayer today.
Things I want.
just give me what I need. When I complain from time to time, forgive me, Lord, I pray. Thank y'all for tuning in and listening to us today. A couple of things. I do have a Top Shelf Ministries cookbook. You can find us on the web. And here's a few of our CDs that we have. This one is the only two-pack. Everything else is singles. The prices are on our website at www.topshelfministries.com. You put it on the top shelf if you're going to put it on the top shelf for Jesus Christ. And I thank you for allowing us to come into your homes and sharing. I tell you, just continue to share, because like I say, this gospel is going to be preached. And I hope to, if we have room in our motorhome. Deb and I, for you that do not know, we live in our motorhome, but Deb plays the piano. And if we can get that keyboard in here next Saturday night at Live at 5, we're going to try to. I had a request. Somebody wanted me to do Oh, What a Savior. And I don't know if we'd blow the roof off or what. But I have one more song. A friend down in Austin area. This goes for you. Oh, Lord, my God. When I in some wonder consider all the world thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art. Christ shall come, and he's coming. Oh, with shouts of acclamation, oh, he's gonna take us all home. And what joy's gonna fill our hearts. And here's what we'll do. Then I will bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. It sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. I tell you what, I feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit, and I pray that you're feeling it as well, and we praise God. Hey, I want to give you some scriptures today, and our thought today, here's what the Holy Spirit laid upon mine and Deb's heart this week, and she told you about the young lady that said, I just want to pray that you help me stay focused. And I know, folks, there's a lot of things going on in this world. I read the book of Matthew, the 24th chapter, and I read where it said there'll be earthquakes in diverse places. And I heard just this week, El Paso, Texas, had a 5.0 earthquake. And the Bible even says when you begin to see these things come to pass, lift up your heads, because your redemption is about to draw nigh. And I thank God that my name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Now, let me just say this, though. If you're here and watching us, or if you've got a loved one that does not know the Lord Jesus Christ as their personal Savior, let me tell you, this is the greatest opportunity for you to share this Facebook post, and I'm not just saying it to get all the views. I'm just saying this is the easiest way for a person to come to know Jesus Christ, because I have found out, Deb, that the Bible says whoever calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And I tell you what, if you have a loved one, if you're there this afternoon watching Live for Five, I'm going to tell you something. You can receive Christ into your heart, and we want to pray with you about it. But let me give you this passage of Scripture that the Lord gave me. Of course, I've got to put on my specs because this print's getting a little bit smaller. Here's the book of Colossians, the 3rd chapter. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affections on things above, not on things on the earth. Now, I pray God's blessing as He blesses the reading of that word. But let me share this with you. When I was beginning to talk about this with Deb, and she said, I'd love to share this testimony about staying focused. And I'm going to tell you, folks, we need to stay focused, not just because the churches are closed, but God's Word is still going forth, and it's accomplishing that which is what it is supposed to do. There's going to be churches that are going to be having drive-up church. I even thought, my goodness, they've got a drive-in movie theater. If you're a pastor out there in Lubbock, Texas, you ought to call that drive-in movie theater. If you don't have any other access, see if they'll do it. I tell people, and a lot of people say, well, Jack, I don't want to bother them. I don't want to. Hey, listen, we have not because we ask not. And I believe that God is telling us today to stay focused upon Him. He said, set your affections on things above and not on things below. I can tell you, you can look around and families are coming together. People are learning how to cook at home. And of course, Deb and I, we cook a lot of times at home. And although we get to go out occasionally and we pray for those people.
Not anymore
here. We don't get to go to the restaurants unless it's a drive up, and we hadn't done that in a while. I take it back. We did go get a hamburger today. I drove up, they gave it to me, and we enjoyed it. So, but that's the first time we've done that in quite a while. But here's what the Word says. And you're maybe asking, Jack, how do you stay focused when there's such turmoil in our society, in our world today? And, of course, we all know about the virus, and that's our big thing that we are all facing. And I believe it with all my heart. The reason is because we are all uncertain what tomorrow's going to bring. But the good news is I know who holds tomorrow, because I know He holds my hand. And when I thought about how do you stay focused, here's what the Holy Spirit showed me. He said over there in the book of Hebrews chapter 12, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And I'm telling you, Deb, today, and all of you that are watching us and that are going to share this, I encourage you to share this, because who knows? The reason that somebody makes it to heaven is because you might have taken time to share this today. But that word, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, I realized one interpretation said, fix your eyes upon Jesus. And I pray today, folks, it's about Jesus Christ. If you've never invited Jesus Christ into your heart and your life, we're going to ask God to, right now, would you just pray with us? Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for allowing us to go into these homes and across this live stream. And Lord, I just pray that the Holy Spirit, if there's one person out there, you know who it is, that they may not know you as their Lord and Savior. They may not have a relationship with you. And I just ask you right now, Holy Spirit, to quicken their heart and just, Lord, help them to just pray the prayer of faith and just invite you, Lord, Jesus, into my heart. I receive you. And I pray for those that have lost that passion for God. And I ask you, Lord, to do like we read in the book of Psalms. It said, create in us a new heart and a right spirit. And we praise you for this opportunity. And may God richly bless each and every one as we go about our days, because we know who holds our hand, and we give you praise for it in Jesus' name. Hey, again, you can donate to our ministry. Go to Top Shelf Ministries, or Cash App is the easiest way we can get our funds. There's a donate button, I do believe, there on live stream. PayPal is also on there as well. Hey, but God bless you, folks. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next Saturday. And we pray that you will just send us your prayer request and that God be glorified. God bless you today. 5 o'clock next Saturday.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, y'all. I think we're off. No, we're not off. Oh, there it is.